What's up, guys? It's Professor Fangly here, and just before I actually react to this news video of Cuz of Snivy, and also, good job of almost getting 900 subscribers, Cuz, by the way. Just want to say that, and also, I want to do, like, some news. It's the reason about uploads. I won't be able to upload because I went relaxed for a while. Because I've been out with band, and band just tired me out so much. I just don't feel like uploading as much. Besides watching videos, because, well, these are the easiest videos I can make, just saying. So anyway, I'm thinking like around like the week on Christmas, or week before Christmas, I'll do the live stream thing as I did last year. So, just to say that, like last year, I'll do the live stream and have some fun with you guys. Yeah, that's out of the way. Let's watch the Pokémon Guardean of Hope episode 8.
Okay, I brought Pika.
Of course.
Alright, now we can get started.
Hold up. We should make sure that this information is accurate. Does it come from a credible source?
Yes, it does. Me.
Okay. Stepstone is the evolution machine. Okay.
You? Have you been holding back information?
I have, but only the information that I deemed irrelevant.
But in light of... A little color, but it was to do.
Recent events, I felt that this information needs to be known.
Exactly what information do you have?
Well, I'm sure you're aware of our main threat, the
Bitter Cold. Yes, of course.
Yeah, of course we do. What about it?
Yes, well, the Bitter Cold isn't a Pokemon. Pika and Curtis know this already.
Yep.
Correct?
That's correct, that's because Pika... I really love the Pokemon Missing Dungeon because that is actually the first Pokemon game I actually played by my pastime, but after the snow area, when you first arrived there, it's way before you meet the vehicle, of course, but when I went to that cave, I just constantly die, like, there's no point just me just stopping, like, it's just never gonna work.
So the ice pistol thing.
Sure, I would have gone with Demonic Snowflake, but sure, Ice Crystal thing.
Yeah.
Are you sure? Because it looks like a normal Cryogonal.
Oh, that's a hard word to...
In any case...
That's a hard word to actually, like, speak to me.
It's not. In fact, as we know, it feeds off negative energy.
Mm-hmm.
Jade, it seems that you're ramping up to something. Would you mind just cutting to the chase?
My apologies. Okay, then, I'll just come out with it. The Bitter Cold is not of this world.
Huh?
Wait, so we're dealing with an alien?
Well, technically. This being traverses different dimensions rather than different planets, though.
Yeah. Traveling by different dimensions, not different planets, so it's not going through the light speed of time. So it's not from the dimension right here, like the Pokemon. This isn't a different world, this universe, it's different than the... After universe from the main series games. Because in this universe, humans don't exist. They're just talking Pokemon that live in this universe we're doing right now. And that's all about it, about this universe. It's just that the form Wester's Claws because of the Misty Dungeons, blah 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 blah. That's how the story of the Misty Dungeon, blah 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 blah.
Trials Dimensions seeking destruction based upon the negative energy of that dimension's inhabitants. It destroys the dimensions and moves on to the next.
Oh!
I'd hate to think of what'll happen to our world if we don't stop it. Pardon me for saying, but why didn't the ones in the other world stop it? Surely they didn't want to see their world destroyed. I'm sure they tried, but they didn't have the information on how to win, like we do.
Yeah.
Finally, what I'm here for. How do we beat it?
It's simple. To defeat a being from another world, we need beings of another world. We need beings who haven't experienced our world's negative energy.
Huh.
I guess that's where we come in, right?
That's right. In fact, all three humans were brought here to stop the Bitter Cold's plan.
Yep, because it is one of the humans. Because he just mysteriously come into this war by some mysterious dreams that come in the missing dungeon get way to the Finny game. This is why this story contrasts with the missing dungeon games, those series games. So it's from the storyline goes from JC Infinity, then comes the Guardian of Hope, then the Light of Hope, I believe is the name of the game is.
Charles, you were sent to stop the first attempt, the meteor. While it wouldn't destroy the planet, it would have deeply affected morale.
Wait, Charlie, when you stepped in and stopped the first attempt? Wait, this might be something from the Hoenn games. Like, I did know the Hoenn games by the remakes about the whole split timeline with the multiverses. Yes.
Tag, you were sent to repair the time rift that the Bitter Cold created when it tried to freeze the timeline.
Huh.
And Curtis, you were sent to destroy the biggest and most dangerous energy collector, the one that stole the Rainbows of Hope.
Huh.
You were all brought back once we knew you were needed to defeat
guess
the
that's from the...
once and for all.
Do we have any other means to defeat this?
Maybe the beginning of the...
Or was it just us for...
Leon and Guardians of Hope? The Guardian Gates of Infamy I met, guys.
In fact, we have two secret weapons.
Two secret weapons? Well, what are they?
Our first is Echo.
The
me?
Eve?
What
oh.
can I do that makes me a secret weapon?
You may remember picking a Grisadia flower when you were young, but it wasn't the normal red.
No, it wasn't. It was a blue flower.
That's right. This mutated Grisadia flower is extremely rare. It grants the shaman to power absorb any kind of pollutant, including negative energy.
Huh.
But it comes at a price. The shaman can neither fly nor change back to landform. They're widely considered cursed.
Mutated Grisadias, multiple worlds, a dimension-eating demon? This is all starting to sound like some sort of bad fanfiction.
Yes, it is, Curtis.
What?
Never mind.
I kinda agree with you, Curtis.
You were saying something about secret weapons?
Right, yes. The second was being researched by the Bitter Cold. In fact, your friend Gary was part of those experiments. Forced evolution.
Forced evolution?
Oh yeah, why the...
It is.
Gujra!
Or at least it was. During the war, the ones who built this base created a machine that could force Pokémon to evolve. Unfortunately, the machine is not functional right now.
Aww.
But if it doesn't work, then how can it be used as a weapon?
You guys can fix it. You're supposed to fix it.
How?
Well, I could take a look. Where is it?
Jade, do you really think that's such a good idea?
It's our only chance. There's no way this group of unevolved Pokemon can defeat the Bitter Cold.
Hey!
But I did saw the last page of the Guardians of Hope, by the way. Not gonna spoil it, guys. You just have to find out for yourself.
As long as you don't tell it, I guess it's okay.
But I cannot wait till they voice at it. But it's pretty sad,
wow.
though. Just saying.
There are a lot of tunnels.
Okay, here's one hint about the ending. It's kind of the same to like all the Pokemon in the games at the end. That's your hint.
Because the building was compromised.
But that's not all they were used for, are they?
No, of course not. Some of these passages were used for storage, such as this one.
Oh. Okay.
Is that the machine?
Wow, that's small.
Well, this is kind of weird.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, it's like something out of some cheap science fiction.
I agreed.
What? Nothing.
Tag?
Okay, could it just keep saying like something about science fiction, fan fiction?
I'm not gonna turn it on. I just need to examine it. Well. I guess the worst thing that can happen is it doesn't work. Hopefully. Well, I don't know why I expected that to work.
Wow.
Huh?
What? Happening?
Is something wrong?
No, I'm fine. It's just...
What happened? The time gears! Those guys! In the second game, these are one of the main important parts of the story. These are called the time gears. They keep time in bounds. If you play the second games, of course. The second games of the Missy series.
Tag? Tag, are you alright?
Yes. Fine.
Tag, what happened?
My dimensional scream activated.
What's a dimensional scream? I don't know that ability.
It's a rare ability in which the user can see into the past or future. These visions usually give a hint at what the user needs to do.
Huh.
How did you know that?
That's not important. Tag, you were gonna say something about the vision?
We have like a little history going on with Curtis.
Right. I saw 5 time gears.
Curtis, I have like something to tell. An idea, like, about your past adventures 2 years before this event. Yes, that's right, the Guardians of the Gates of Infinity series.
There are 5 time gears. The 6th is known as the space gear.
Huh.
The space
that's
gear?
That's to me.
Where can we find this space gear?
It is at the top of Giant Volcano.
Really?
Giant Volcano?
Really, like, that's a big, like, weird name, not to lie.
Miles and I were there a few years ago.
Yes, I know, and you'll need to go back there again. And where are the time gears?
If I had to guess...
Temple Tower, of course.
That's where Tag and Miles left them. Again? How did you know that?
Curtis, you and I are gonna have a talk in the morning.
Okay.
And when we collect the gears, what will we do then?
We can use them to activate the machine. Are you sure?
Well, kind of implies that we want to take the time gear that slows time. Well, it's pretty much stops time,
this
actually.
This is the best chance we've got. 2/3 of our group are not in their strongest form. We need this machine if we want to win this fight.
If strength is the trouble, then we can train.
I'm afraid there isn't time. Based on the strike tonight, it won't be long until the next.
I think Jade is right. We don't have much time. We need to find the gears fast. Miles and I will talk to Grovyle and Celebi. Maybe they can help us with the time gears.
Then, my parents, Curtis and I, will see what information we can find in the space gear.
I assume you mean in the morning.
I agree. This is late. Oh no, not this type of video! Oh my gosh, Curtis. Really, Curtis? You gotta be kidding me. Just saying, dude, you need to stop, like, doing, like... You will see why, guys. That's what the Curtis Ivy. Oh, and I guess that's his true... Oh, I see. Oh, Curtis Ivy is actual name, I see. But not the real Curtis, of course. Not the actual human Curtis. I know that Curtis is actual being because, well, who's making this comic? And see, guys, this is what I don't want. Like, this is completely useless. Curtis, I'm just kind of confused, like, I know that some other YouTubers did this, but it's been a fixed mistake. But, why not this? Well, anyway, thanks so much for watching this video, guys. Curtis, I cannot wait till you start the Light of Hope series, and pretty soon, if so, if you need, like, voice acting, like, I can be able to help. I'd be happy to. If I... can talk like a little bit more faster, but this is my actual speed at the moment I can stand. But YouTube is making me groan, so that's just it. So I'm just going to go to bed since it's like 9:46, you can see. And yeah, thanks so much for this, guys. See you in the next guys, of course. The professor is out.